Alright, thank you. Just so you guys know, there are some Jews here. There's a couple Jews here, so I was really looking forward to what you had to say about us. I decided to sit in the back and be extra quiet and be like, I want to know what they think of us. When they're all sitting around eating ham. Saving all year for their Christmas presents. That's mind-blowing, by the way, to me, is that you guys like spent every cent you have on Christmas presents and then start saving for the next year on December 26th. That's the only thing that Jews don't understand about you guys. I live in the East Village. Come over. We can hang out. We'll sit in my kitchen and hold up to 3 people. And we'll talk about how much we wish the air conditioner worked. But because I live in the East Village, there's a lot of bars and there's a lot of restaurants. So it's pretty much a guarantee that if I'm walking home at 3:30 or 4 o'clock in the morning, without fail, I will walk by a woman crying. And it makes sense because the East Village has all the ingredients that could end a night in tears. Those ingredients, of course, being alcohol and women. So every time I walk by them, I like to write little haikus for them. Here's one. Vodka, cranberry, gin and tonic, Pinot, Grige, this will end in tears. Bartender, shots please. She just broke up with Steve. Then she loved him. Cue tears. Three Chardonnays in. He still hasn't texted back. He never cares. Cue tears. Girls' night out, no boys. Don't invite Christina, slut. She heard that. Cue tears. So I actually just broke up with my girlfriend recently. I blame alcohol. And I've been trying to figure out how long after a breakup before it's socially acceptable to reactivate your OkCupid account. What do you guys say, 3 to 4 minutes after? So you are 1 to 2 minutes? Before she gets to the bottom of your stairs, you're on your bed, head in hands, answering questions about how important faith is to you in a relationship. What about 2 hours before you break up? When you guys sit down to dinner and she wants to talk about who's contributing more to this relationship? What about 3 months before that? When you meet all her friends for the first time and when she asks them what they think of you, they all agree you're pretty annoying. What about 5 months before that? When she says, Charles, I love you. And you say, no, you don't. You don't even know me. What about 11 months before that? When you guys go out to your first like dinner and a date, like dinner and a movie date, and then your credit card gets rejected and she pays for everything the whole night, And then she looked at you and says, "Is this what this is going to be?" And you say, "Yeah." We can always just eat peanut butter sandwiches in my apartment. Would you like to do that instead? What about 1 year before she even met you, when she got cheated on by her boyfriend at that time and then never relearned how to trust? Someone, that's the time, huh? That's what you know? Somebody knocked on my door the other day, and I wasn't expecting anybody to come over. And if somebody knocks on my door, and I'm not expecting anybody to come over, there is literally no chance in hell that I'm gonna answer the door. No chance. I owe Con Edison $800. I owe my landlord $3,000. And when you do that, you have a couple options. You can A, not order the crab cake Benedict at brunch on Saturday, and the lobster frittata at brunch on Sunday, which, let's face it, not gonna happen. You can B, go back in time to when you were filling out college applications, knock the pen out of your hand and say, "No, no college." Or you can C, avoid your landlord at all costs. Don't answer any emails, don't answer any phone calls, don't answer your door, buy a mask so when you leave your apartment and someone's like, "Hey, Charles," you're like, "No, Richard Nixon." I'm Richard Nixon, but like Charles guy, he's upstairs, you should get him. He owes you a lot of money. How did I know that? No reason. What's that? But I fucked up really big time the other day because I pocket called my landlord at 1:30 in the morning on Tuesday. Normal human beings, when they realize they're being pocket called, hang up after about a minute. Here's my question to you. How long will somebody stay on the phone talking to nobody if that person that they think they're talking to owes them $3,000? What do you guys think? 5 minutes and 37 seconds. Doesn't sound so long. Talking to nobody. If I had 5 minutes and 37 seconds, I'd show you how long I was to talk to nobody. But I don't. Do I? No. Pack line up tonight. I got the email.